Assuming the network cables are connected and we've successfully run the configuration wizard, then we're ready to set up our input and output patching. The patching will tell the devices what inputs and outputs to expect, and that includes the analog connections. If we're patching to and from MTX devices, we can find access to the patching at the top of each channel. Simply open the window and select. If we move to the external I/O tab, we can patch in a number of ways. Firstly, we can choose what to put onto any of the 16 WIDIF channels from each device, and that includes selecting inputs or outputs to and from any input expander or amplifier. The analog patch is where you choose to route to the amplifiers via analog. Provided you've selected one or more in your device configuration, then when you click on the output patch for one of these devices, you'll be offered the available amplifier inputs. In the Dante section, we can see the same type of patch matrix as we get in Dante Controller. Along the top side are the transmitting devices that are sending audio, and along the left are the receiving devices. If we open up the envelopes here, we can see that the MRX7D has 64 outputs and the MTX-5D has 16. If I then open up a Dante-equipped XMV amplifier, then click Edit, I can use the cross selector to choose a destination channel like this. As I mentioned in a previous video, there is a box labeled Preserve the Dante Settings configured in Dante Controller. Now, if you're using devices in the Yamaha CIS range such as these, then all you have to do is do Dante patching from this editor software. If you're incorporating other products such as a QL1 mixer or a Dante microphone or an EXO amplifier, for example, then you'll need to patch it all in Dante Controller and then tick that box, and it will import the settings to use them with MTX Editor. Further along the top, we get to this EXI8 tab and the XMV tabs. These are patching duplicates of what we saw in the external I/O tab, along with additional parameters such as gain or phantom power, etc. For patching to and from MRX7, this needs to be done in the MRX Designer. For more details, please watch the MRX specific videos.